The crew of a merchant ship, including two Filipinos, now safe after a botched hijack attempt off the coast of Yemen. U.S. Navy forces took into custody five pirates who boarded the MV Central Park, which is owned by an Israeli businessman. Just recently, Houthi rebels hijacked an Israeli-linked cargo ship, the Galaxy Leader, with 25 crew members on board, including 17 Filipinos. Houthi rebels said they carried out the attack in retaliation for Israel's offensive against Palestinians. Meanwhile, Philippine Senator Aimee Marcos wants the Foreign Affairs Department and Migrant Workers Department to work on a long-term strategy for negotiating the release of abducted Filipino seafarers. Marcos, who chairs the Senate Committee on Foreign Relations, says there is no end in sight to the Israel-Hamas conflict, which means more Filipino seafarers could become collateral damage. Filipino seafarers comprise 25% of those employed in the global maritime industry.
The Filipino national freed from captivity in Gaza is set to return to the Philippines before Christmas. Jimmy Pacheco has been released from the hospital where he received a warm send-off from the staff. According to Foreign Affairs Undersecretary Eduardo de Vega, Pacheco was unharmed when he was held captive by Hamas militants. Pacheco also told Philippine officials of his intent to continue working. Pacheco was among those released by Hamas militants on the first day of its four-day truce with Israel.
The first words they uttered, well, he was more of crying, no? But the first words that he uttered were that he thanked God and wanted to live for his family. The second things he was talking about was, what's the future? What's the plan? And he was saying that it's not to come home. I mean, he was convinced or fortified, meaning he was resolute in his decision that he needed to continue earning money, good money as a caregiver. He's only 33 years old. Mm-hmm. Although Israel is going to give him a pension of sorts, it doesn't mean that he feels himself retired. He would like to continue working. So that's what he was telling our ambassador.
Meanwhile, the Philippine government is still confirming reports 60-year-old Filipino Noralyn Babadilla was also abducted by Hamas. Back here at home, Vice President Sara Duterte calls for respect over the Philippines' potential return to the International Criminal Court. Duterte spoke Monday at the sidelines of an education event in Manila. Her comments follow the remarks of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. that Manila's return to the fold is under study. The Philippines withdrew from the ICC in 2019 under the presidency of Duterte's father. Rodrigo Duterte's bloody anti-drug campaign is now the subject of a probe by the ICC, in which the Marcos administration previously rejected to cooperate with.
We all should respect the position of the president, being the chief architect of foreign policy. Pero we will continue to reach out to the Department of Justice regarding our position on this matter.
Two erstwhile Philippine Justice Secretaries await action by the Ombudsman on the request for a probe by former Senator Laila De Lima. Now, this follows an order by the appellate court for the Ombudsman to investigate Minardo Guevara and Vitaliano Aguirre III. That's over their supposed roles in De Lima's years-long detention. Guevara, now Solicitor General, insists his actions then as DOJ chief were within the bounds of the law. He also said the Ombudsman did not err in previously dismissing her complaint. As for Aguirre, he's choosing to stay mum until told to comment by the Ombudsman.
The Philippine Interior and Local Government Secretary asserts law-breaking policemen have no place in the force. This after a former police chief discharged a firearm in a Quezon City bar on Sunday. Secretary Benhur Abalos says he has ordered a thorough probe on the case. He has also ordered a comprehensive background check on Police Lieutenant Colonel Mark Julio Abong. Abalos called Abong's actions an abuse of power and authority. The secretary assured the public justice will be served and the full force of law would be applied if Abong is found guilty. Abalos also concurrently serves as the chair of the National Police Commission.
Two Chinese fighter jets orbited a Philippine aircraft during joint patrols between the Philippines and Australia in the West Philippine Sea. Let's get more details now from our correspondent, Bianca Dava. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. Good afternoon. Two Chinese fighter jets orbited a Philippine aircraft during the joint patrols of Manila and Canberra in the West Philippine Sea on Sunday. Armed Forces of the Philippines Chief General Romeo Bronner Jr. said the two People's Liberation Army jets of China circled the Philippine Air Force's A-29B Super Tucano for about 15 minutes. Despite this, the Philippine aircraft successfully accomplished its task. According to Bronner, the Chinese jets' actions were no longer unusual, as they have already done this to the Japanese aircraft and U.S. aircraft in the South China Sea in the past. But the AFP chief asserted that the Philippines was well within its rights to conduct joint patrols with allies in areas within the country's exclusive economic zone to promote the rules-based international order. The joint maritime and air patrols of the Philippines and Australia will last until today. Bronner said the activity was a success, adding no untoward incidents have been reported. Last week, the Philippines and the United States also conducted a three-day joint maritime and air patrol in the West Philippine Sea, with a Chinese warship also shadowing their activity. Defense Secretary Gilberto Chiloro Jr. believes Manila's maritime cooperative activities, or MCAs, with partners and allies are a sustainable endeavor. The defense and military officials are also hopeful that multilateral patrols with other like-minded nations in the West Philippine Sea will be conducted soon. Ron?
Bianca Dava with that story. Thanks.